Good morning, everyone. So, first of all, I convey my thanks to Professor Dadia for asking me to speak on diagnosis of labia in this instruction course. As we all know, amblyopia words has been originated from two Greek words, amblyos meaning dullness or blunt and ops meaning vision. So basically amblyopia is nothing but the dullness or decreased vision. It may be unilateral or less often or bilateral reduction of best corrected visual acuity that usually occurs in the setting of otherwise normal eye. It results from the abnormal processing of visual images which leads to reduced visual acuity. For unilateral amblyopia, practically a difference in best corrected visual acuity of two central lines between the two eyes is taken. And for bilateral amblyopia, the visual acuity should be less than 20/40 in each eye to label it as amblyopia. So broadly, amblyopia can be divided into these types based on the underlying mechanism. The refractive amblyopia, which can be either isometropic, anisometropic, or even meridional, can also be included in the refractive. Then strabismic amblyopia, refractive and strabismic combined, and image degradation or the stimulus deprivation amblyopia. So if we see that 90% of the cases are either because of anisometropia or strabismus or combination of all these. So clinical characteristics which characterize the amblyopia decreased vision is, it is associated with the decreased stereo acuity. There is fixation reflex abnormalities and pattern changes, crowding phenomena and effect of the neutral density filter on the visual acuity and decreased contrast sensitivity. So basically to look into all these characteristics of amblyopia, for diagnosis we need a thorough clinical history, evaluation of the visual acuity, determination of the fixation pattern, binocular alignment and ocular motility testings, thorough ocular examination including pupillary and fundus examination, binocularity and stereoacuity testing and neutral density filter test and testing for the crowding phenomena. So testing of visual acuity in children above 5 years is usually not a problem because they are verbal children and they know we can use Snellen letters chart or Snellen number chart, Logmar chart or any other chart most of the time unless null the child is not cooperative. In 3 to 5 years also we can easily assess visual acuity using either the Allen picture charts or tumbling E charts, Leo symbol or HOTV charts. Is it basically to make a child understand between age 3 to 5 years about this. So some art is required in checking visual acuity in children between 1 to 3 years of age. So we can use the common charts like dot visual acuity test or most commonly use miniature toy test where the child can identify and can extend his hand to catch hold of this toy. Similarly, we can use the marble game test or Sheridan's ball test. Less than 1 year, again, it's really tricky. So preferential looking test is very useful in this age. Then, of course, optogenetic nystagmus and VER can be used. So having evaluation of the visual acuity in infants is really tricky. So basically what we want to use is use the fixation reflex or the fixation pattern, and the CSM method is a useful tool to assess visual acuity in children between 3 to 12 months. Here what we see that the central steady and maintained fixation implies a good vision in both eyes. Alternate fixation again good visual acuity in both the eyes. Then central but strong preference for the other eye indicates that vision is bit less in that eye as compared to the other. And central but not maintained vision is slightly moderate loss of vision is there. And unsteady fixation and no fixation at all means there is a marked loss of vision or defective vision is marked. Then fixation pattern we can check with the use of visuoscope monocularly. Note if fixation is steady, unsteady, central or non-central, all these points should be noted. And this has been classified into central fixation, eccentric fixation, non-fovular or no fixation at all. So this is how we can check with the help of a visuoscope, even with your direct ophthalmoscope, the fixation pattern. Then to illustrate crowding phenomena, because in Crowding phenomena refers that when the amblyopic patient, they have better vision when tested with the single optotype as compared to the when we check with this two or three linear line charts. So this occurs because of the counter interaction between the neighboring test targets because of lateral innervation to amblyopia. So in amblyopia, vision will improve, while in other conditions it will not improve with the single lateral chart. Then similarly, we can use the neutral density filter test also. Neutral density filter, what it does, it reduces the overall luminance without inducing a color change. So decreased luminance of the visual target results in diminished central acuity in normal as well as in patient with the organic amblyopia. However, in functional amblyopia, there is no effect on the visual acuity in this vision. So hence, we can use it to differentiate the organic versus functional amblyopia. Then contrast sensitivity reduction in the contrast sensitivity is more for the higher frequencies in amblyopic patients, and it has been seen that it improves during amblyopia therapy and thus is very useful to monitor the progress of the amblyopia therapy. Contrast threshold becomes normal in strabismic amblyopia when luminance levels were reduced and the deficit persists in anisometropic amblyopia. Pelli-Robson chart sensitivity can be used as shown here. Then stereo acuity, the presence of amblyopia can be detected by defective performance on various stereograms also. The simplest is the two pencil test. It is clinically useful and can be applied even when visual acuity recording is unreliable or not possible. So it other stereo acuity charts can also be used. We can use even the tetramus fly test, random dot stereograms. The two pencil test can be used by the vertical or even the horizontal also we can use it. Then once you have diagnosed amblyopia based on the visual acuity and absence of other causes of the visual acuity and all the characteristic features of the reduced visual acuity, then we must grade into, because for prognosis and further management we need it. We have to decide the approach for amblyopia therapy based on whether it is a mild amblyopia, vision 6-9 to 6-12, moderate amblyopia, vision worse than 6-12 to 6-36, and severe amblyopia when vision is worse than 6-36. After this, we should also note down what are the various positive factors and negative factors for prognosis of the amblyopia management, because we need to tell to the parents about all this, and we need to tailor our approach also based on this. So positive prognostic factors include it's always a functional amblyopia, central fixation, positive random dot stereopsis, short duration of the amblyopia, and young patient, and especially the motivated parents who get treated their child. So we can say that the amblyopia diagnosis, early detection is most important, because early detection and intervention is in critical age group ensures full recovery and restoration of binocular vision. So that should be the early diagnosis should be the aim. So this small mnemonic has been used for early diagnosis, especially in younger children less than 1 year. So that is MEEK approach. M stands for monitor qualitative fixation. Then E stands for evaluation of the red reflex by the using Bruckner test, and then alignment evaluation using Hirschberg test in infants and cover test in toddlers, and compare the refractive error by doing cyclopegic refraction between the two eyes. So these are the some factors which help in early detection in especially children where visual acuity testing is not possible. So to conclude, I would like to say that amblyopia diagnosis and management is a challenge, especially in younger children. But it's very rewarding, and the parents really are thankful to you because patient gets vision for the whole of his life. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Any questions to sir? Anybody wants to ask anything? Sir, your comments.
It's not improving. And every ophthalmologist tries. Every ophthalmologist tries to, you know, find some problem in the refractive error has been not corrected. But one, you should always keep in mind that this patient must have had some unusual refractive error in his childhood. And now one eye has gone amblyopic. Because a patient who has a bilateral hypermetrope V1-3, because any hypermetrope more than 2, and I mean isometropic amblyopia also are liable to go into amblyopia. At least if there is a difference, even one, वन एक एक दो होगा एक तीन होगा देन ऑल्सो दे कैन गो. सो यू मस्ट ऑलवेज कीप इन माइंड दैट सच पेशेंट्स मस्ट हैव हैड एम्ब्लॉयमेंट इन द चाइल्डहुड व्हिच नाउ दे आर नॉट इम्प्रूविंग. सो यू इट इज नॉट द रिफ्रैक्टिव एरर प्रॉब्लम.